Day 15. We're really jumping through the days now. So is that 5-6 days later? Let's see here.
Henry. Henry, wake up.
Uh-oh. Hold on.
And pick up the radio.
Hold on, Delilah. Here I go.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Uh-oh, she's been drinking again.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good. Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Well, that was a weird call. That was a very, very strange call. All right, everybody, welcome in. Day 33, here we go. Let's see here. Where are we at here? Supply drop thoroughfare. Hike
north. Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
All right, let's see where we're off to here.
Hey, so
to the supply drops.
Who's
let's
Jules?
Just keep to the thing.
I mean, I assume it's your ex.
Yeah, that had to be a dream.
I don't mean to pry.
How do you know that name? I haven't said anything about Julia.
How is that even possible?
Is there something going on that I don't know about?
What? No. Look, a couple of weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night, and you were talking in your sleep, I guess. I only heard the name Julia, so I figured I'd ask.
It's hard to talk about.
You don't have to.
It's hard because, well, I fucked up.
We all fuck up. But being out here can't be some sort of punishment for you. Whatever you did can't be that bad, and if it is, it's in the past.
She got really early Alzheimer's and I lost her. She's still alive. She's being taken care of back in Australia because that's where she's from. She's there.
God, Henry.
And that's it.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Henry, listen. My God, I'm so sorry you've gone through that. I don't know if you've thought of it this way, but her family is taking care of her, and you need to take care of you.
Thanks.
I'll let you keep hiking.
All right, let's see here. So we're going down to the supply drop. We got to make a sharp right here. Up we go. Hiking to retrieve the supplies. Yep, straight ahead, all full. What does this sign say here? Supply. Oh, supply drop. Perfect. Where is it at? Oh, here we go. This has got to be it. Perfect. Oops. 2, 3, and 4. Go. Food for another lookout. Food for Two Forks lookout. Food for other lookout. That's kind of funny. Okay, well, we'll pick up mine, I guess.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
So we have to head back home here, I guess.
All right. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Oh, wow, day 64. Really cranking along now.
I have been out here for 2 months. My beard is wearing thin.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
All right. The flapjack.
So, no ideas, huh?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it.
The June Fire it is.
So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
As much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice.
Yeah.
I wish I was over there.
Delilah's hitting on me.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk. radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Whoa. Wait a minute, tell me. Tell me. Hey there, Delilah. Is there something you want to tell me? You are far away on a radio.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me,
catch
I
a
keep
fish,
hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Which way is the lake? I thought it was that way. Is it this way around? You know what? Let me just put this down here really quick. Please set that right there. Where's my map? Where are we at here? Yeah, I'm telling you, it is, to the west of me. Let's see here. Uh-oh, I'm not going the right way. I'm gonna go back the other way here.
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
Right there.
What the? It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we
yeah,
said
what
to each other,
about.
Have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried.
The heck is
you didn't
that?
Find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating. Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
That's a weird noise. Is it on my map, maybe? Sounds like I'm getting further away from it for some reason. Something's behind me now. Oh, here it is. Shit. Oh my god, this scared the crap out of me.
Henry, are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with... what? Transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
I don't... what the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you. This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
There are people listening to our conversations. The person or these people were hiding in the bushes down here. What the fuck, Dee?
I don't know, Henry. This sounds crazy.
Yeah, and you're not the one who just saw our words on a clipboard out in the middle of nowhere.
Those words were from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. I'll hike out there and get some answers.
Great. Just keep a clear head. Don't, you know, do anything crazy.
Like taking a job in the middle of nowhere with literally no escape from whatever or whoever is out there?
Well, I meant, like, kill anybody.
You got it, boss.
Wow. So, there's... not really sure why. There's really no reason.
Whoa, Delilah, there's a big chain link fence between me and the meadow. I don't think I can get past it.
A fence?
Yeah.
How big?
Big. It goes off in both directions, acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
That would be exciting. We're definitely not going this way. There's a door.
And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Okay. I've given it the good college try. No dice.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should leave Pike right now.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.
All right, where are they at? Look for controlled burn south of Ruby River. So, let's see here. Oh, jeez. That is so freaking far away. That's way the hell down there. Alright, so we'll go deck down to the river, we'll cut across, and we'll go down. Alright, back to the river here. Climb back up here. Let's see here, which way do we go here? This will work to the left. So we gotta go all the way down to Ruby River. Try to get to like catch 307 and then we can go to the scout camp down there. It's like a best way to go, I think. Thank you. There's my lookout point.
Should we call the cops or the Forest Service and let them know this is going on?
Don't you think that would sound, you know, crazy?
Yeah, it is crazy. We have to tell someone.
Tell them what, Henry? Tell them we're being stalked and you were attacked and we don't have any proof?
I don't know. Tell them we're being bothered or something.
Henry, like this job, okay? And if I give off even a hint of cuckoo to my bosses, they are never gonna let me come back out here. Do you understand that?
All right, I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
Okay, keep your radio close to you.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry.
It's just a thought.
I don't know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No. Okay, let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have a good feeling. I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police. I was thinking about the Goodwins. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
I'm sure he's fine, Delilah. I mean, don't you think if this started happening to them, he or his dad would have said something?
I don't know. Ned was a weird guy.
No, nobody is that weird. The moment you hear someone in the bushes or get punched from the shadows, you're getting your boss on the phone.
Yeah.
Brian is fine.
I hope so.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
This leads me to our lookout point here, at least. And then from here, we can just go a little bit further south, past the Ruby River, and then we would be... Imagine actually climbing all this. I'm getting winded just watching. Oh, jeez. Alright, so let's break out the map here. So we just keep going straight ahead here. Should I check the house? You know what? I'm just gonna check the house here really quick. I mean, I got knocked out and everything, so I don't want to do it like. I mean, might as well check the house while we're passing by anyway. looks pretty normal. Nothing out of play, so. Okay. Just checking. The June fire is still going. South of Ruby River, so we gotta go across here. There's Ruby River down here. There's controlled burn right there, I think. Yeah, I bet you that's it. I don't think I've opened up this one. This is definitely not been opened here. And four. Perfect. Lots. Lots of books. Old toilet paper. See what that does to my map here. Let's see. Perfect. So if we go up here and stay to the left.
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to two forks. Someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river. There should be a pond on the way.
Got it. What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
There's an old pond out here, not much more than a pile of mud. Do you have it on your map?
Yeah, I know where you are.
Yeah? Where am I?
Pork Pond. There used to be a sign up for it, but, well, folks kept stealing it.
Because it's called Pork Pond?
It's a good goddamn name. That sign would look great in a den, or, you know, anywhere.
Something about men organizing boys around their ideals never sat right with me.
Beware weebelows in large numbers.
Beware of anyone in large numbers. The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
I can get across over here. I think that's where I'm supposed to go anyway. I'm gonna head back here. Totem pole.
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
What type of nerdy hobbies are we talking about with him? Like, a marching band?
Oh, no. Like, comics, model rockets, wizards and wyverns, you know.
Ugh.
Hey, thanks to Brian, I can almost recall by memory the armor classes of most dragons.
The what? No, you can't.
Hey, planar dragon's armor class. Let's see.
Okay, no, I believe you. We're good. I guess these little shelters are where they keep the weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
That's gonna come in handy.
Hey, D, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
Did it say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching? I mean, mean, you and I aren't very interesting.
Us. They're researching us.
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else, what they do.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Alright, so on my way back to Wapiti Station here. Wonder how I get my axe back up, though. Let's see here. So we gotta go all the way back that way. Alright, so let's just go back to Two Forks. Uh-oh, invisible wall. Invisible wall! Alright, it's fine. Let's get out of here. I'm stuck in invisible wall. Hello? That's pretty weird. A little glitchy over there. Alright, let's see here. Well, this just goes back that way anyway. Here. Okay. Oh, this looks promising. This looks very promising.
Hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck. there isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios.
Well, what about when I heard you talking to someone else?
I just left your line open. That's not what this is. Get in your tower. Shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Oh, wow. For day 77.
Thoroughfare Tower. This is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today. The June fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
Wow, she's perky.
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
All right.
Just, you know, have a look at it. Make sure it's in ship shape.
Okay, yeah, it's up. Why are you acting like this?
Great. Just wonderful. Do you see the tree in the top row, second from the left?
Sure. It's the,
No. You don't need to tell me. Just, internalize it. It's a great tree. And there's an area called, that tree's name in your sector that maybe you should take a midday hike to. Maybe.
Cottonwood. She wants me to go here.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Maybe I should go for a hike.
Cottonwood.
Nothing like an afternoon in the Rockies, I tell ya. Radio me the moment you get there.
Cottonwood Creek. She wants me to go back to Cottonwood Creek for some reason. Wow. We're gonna have to figure out going back to Cottonwood Creek. There's something definitely going on. And you know what? We're going to have to find out on the next episode. Tune in tomorrow. My name's Maximum Power. Thanks for joining me on Firewatch. You guys have a great night. Really appreciate it. Thanks.